So, for those who don't know, Banksy recently sold the piece for $100,000. And to be specific, actually, it sold for $166,000. Here's the piece here. And not only did he sell that artwork, but more importantly, what I want to talk about is how he sold a print. So, that is not an original painting, it's actually a print. Yes, you heard right, a print, right? And I want to talk about it because I know a lot of artists always ask, can I sell prints for more? Can I sell prints for more than 20 bucks, 30 bucks, 40 bucks, right? And right now, the artists I work with, I make sure they sell their prints for nothing less than 75 bucks, all the way up to about 400 bucks until they start to build traction. And even then, they raise their prices for their prints even more. But more importantly, I want to talk about the importance of selling your print at the price it's worth, and then also how to raise the value of that print to really get what you deserve. Now, for those who don't know, my name is Jeroy Henry and I help visual artists make consistent art sales using social media. And I wanted to take this time to really share some knowledge with you all because I know a lot of artists want to sell prints because it just takes off the burden of having to try to constantly create new artworks day after day. So prints is a way to really start making more income without putting in more work. And I know that's something a lot of artists want to do, especially in today's time. So with that being said, let's just get straight into it. So first thing first, I want to talk about building the value of a print. What makes a print worth 300 bucks versus 20 bucks, right? Because if you can sell for that $300 for that print, then the profit margin automatically becomes much, much higher. And that's what we want. So first thing first, you have to think about what's going to set your print apart from other prints. Getting the original artwork and taking a photo or getting it scanned to turn it into a print is not enough anymore. That's what everyone is doing. So if you do what everyone do, then your print will be priced in the same category as everyone else's. So what I'm saying is you have to raise the value of that print. Some key things to raise the value of a print is simply embellishing your print. So when I say embellishing your print, it's basically after you receive a print from the printing company, you go behind and you start to hand draw or paint on that print. I'm gonna give you guys an idea. So I worked with an artist a couple years back named James. And what happened with James is that we were selling prints. And we had two prints. We had the original print that was about 250 bucks. And then we had an embellished print. For this embellished print, we literally charged 500 bucks. And the only thing we did to the embellished print was took clear gesso and painted over the canvas to create little brush strokes, right? So we literally painted over the print to create brush strokes. And what this did is it gives people the idea of it being an original. And because of that, people was willing to pay twice the price just because that print was embellished. Now, when I personally think about embellished today, I'm talking about going on top of a print and adding your own little twist, your own little designs, basically like adding more details to that actual print after it's created. And even think outside the box, what are some things you could add to the print after it's created? Maybe like gold leaf. I know that's pretty popular, but you want to think about outside mediums to add to that print as well. Now, once you take your print to the next level, it's automatically going to raise the value of that print. And once the value is raised, then you can charge more because people purchase off of perceived value, right? Now, another thing to raise perceived value is through fame. And this will happen for Banksy. Everyone knows Banksy. We all know Banksy is a huge, huge artist. But the beautiful thing about his fame and how it trickles down to you is that when those prints raise, as far as the price, it allows us as the ones that are not famous to also raise the price because it puts things into perspective, right? So what I'm saying is that once that print sell for $100,000, or to be specific, $166,000, people are more likely to spend more money on prints. Now, I'm not saying that someone is going to buy your print for $100,000. Hopefully they do, right? But more importantly, what I'm saying is that people are willing to pay an extra $100, $200, $300 that understands art because they know the value of a print, especially when you embellish those prints and raise that perceived value. when basically you take that print out the context of being a print, but put it into the context of being an original to really, really gain traction and attention to that print. Because everyone would love to own an original, but a lot of people can't afford an original. But if you can create the illusion of a print being an original, of a print becoming unique, of a print becoming one of a kind, then that value of that print is gonna automatically raise. So taking some keynotes away from this video here, it's okay to sell prints and charge what you believe your print is truly worth. Charging 20, 30, and 40 bucks for a print is simply not enough. Prints prices are starting to raise tremendously. So I think at a minimum, you should be charging at least $75 for that print, all up to maybe 400 bucks. But if you're gonna go into the $400 range, you must embellish that print to raise the perceived value of that print. When you embellish that print, when you add on your own little touches to that print, it's gonna automatically make that print seem to be worth more. And luckily for you, Banksy already did half the job. Banksy already sold the print for $100,000, so you're gonna put it into perspective whenever you're talking to a buyer about the value of a print. Hope you found this valuable. If you made it to this point and you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, press the bell notification, because I heard it works wonders for people like myself that's trying to start a YouTube channel. With that being said, I'm out.